So what if I bought this for a cabin, just to have some place to put safe things? No, we're not storing documents in it. Like, we'll keep those important things in our home, but it did come with a fireproof bag. I don't think I'll use this. My dad was interested in it, so I'm not gonna fireproof and waterproof. I might just give that to him. What I like about this is any of these safes are gonna deter somebody. No safe, unless you're in a bank vault, is going to completely keep somebody out of your stuff. However, this one, just like a lot of pretty much 95%, even the big Liberty safes that you spend $3,000 on, thinner metal on the sides, but this is really thick for the cost of it. I'm surprised. A lot of the weight's in the front, the door, obviously. But what I think is awesome is the space in between the door and the frame. I mean, on this side where the hinges are, which is... This is like the weak points, right? I can't even barely fit my fingernail in there. So that's, if somebody was to get into this and try to pry in, they would have a really, really tough time with a pry bar or anything. I mean, you might be able to fit a putty knife in there, but I mean, there's some pretty big locks there. So length is about 13, depth, I'm sorry, is about 13 and a quarter, call it 14 just to be safe, 15 inches wide, and then about 22 high, and with about a little over 2.5 cubic feet inside. It did come with this firearm short, so like that's the main reason we have it up at the cabin. Now, you could also probably Velcro this on the side if you had documents, if you had a plot plan or something you want to put in there. This fits on the top shelf. But so first of all, obviously three different ways to get in. The biometric fingerprint scanner. And on top of here, it doesn't let up, but lock, unlock, and then a battery warning, a code, and then, which is awesome. You wouldn't even know if it wasn't there. It's like held in there by a magnet. There's your extra USB to get in, your mini USB, and then two keys, which open them right up. Batteries are in here, right? Right up here, somewhere to hang change, jewelry, if that's what you're doing. I actually didn't even notice that the first time I read about it. It's nice that they include it. A full shelf here, and again, fully removable. So if you had something longer that you wanted to or larger that you wanted to store in, you could. What we'll do is probably boom up there, keep our firearm there, and everything else we need to lock up. It's just nice to have. There are, you can't see them, but there are two pre-drilled holes, fabrics over it. So if you choose not to, it looks fine in there. Hardware for that. Those are included, and they are expansion bolts. So as this tightens up. So if you're into a stud, this tightens up and this pulls back and it'll expand into the stud. So really nice option. The only option that you can drill into the bottom, but the option, they're already pre-drilled in the back. What I like about it is when it's open, you can't take the key out, right? So you're not gonna accidentally lock the key in there. To lock though, you just have to hold it shut for 3 seconds, which is absolutely awesome. So really great. Again, two keys, fairly small keys, not marked, which I like. Overall, really nice. And again, this is probably one of the better things about it, the fact that the keyhole is just so absolutely hidden. But easy enough if it does run out of batteries and you have to access those keys, boom. And then look at those bolts, pretty nice and hefty. But again, this is one of the nicest features, that when it's open, you're not gonna lose your key and accidentally drop it in there. My dad's done that before. So really nice safe, really nice for the cost for sure.